Brunswick, USA. Pressure washer perfection.
Hi everybody, it's the original Josh back again with Krenzly USA, pressure washer perfection. So we've diagnosed the issue with your pressure washer is pressure loss, maybe not full pressure loss, partial pressure loss, most likely with pulsation. And one thing I mentioned before is that with an obstructed check valve, you're gonna get pulsation. Now, if you have pressure loss, you shouldn't ever rule out that it's the check valves, even if it's complete pressure loss, because if more than one is damaged, that can be your root cause as well. Some conditions that can cause that failure are debris being sent through the pump, or really harsh freeze conditions in some cases can damage the check valves. Now, the valve housing is freeze-proof. Think about the Krenzly pump, we do say that it is freeze-proof, but some of your wear parts can suffer as a result of a freezing condition. So there's a couple things that can lead to check valve failure. And what we're gonna do now is look at how to remove the check valves, ultimately how to replace the check valves, and most importantly, how to diagnose that the check valves are in fact the problem to begin with. So on the pressure washer pump, we have our pressure gauge right here. This is where we start to try to if you're not familiar with a pressure washer pump, this is where I'm going to tell you to look in order to then find your check valves. So your pressure gauge threads right into the center of the top check valve plug or cap, depending on what name you may refer to it as. There are three across the top and there are three across the front. The three check valves across the front are your low pressure or your intake check valves. The three check valves across the top are considered the high pressure or discharge check valves. In the case of the Krenzly pump, which is the case across all their existing models at the moment, all six of the check valves are identical. So when you take your kit, part number's in your manual. This part number kit is 416-481. Krenzly USA, of course, puts a prefix of 97 in front of it, so ours would be 97416481. That is going to include all six check valves as well as 12 O-rings. And on this particular pump, the other nice thing is that the O-rings that go beneath the check valves are the same as the O-rings for the check valve caps. So right here we've got six check valves and 12 identical O-rings. Now the nice thing about Krenzly's part kits, they also include a diagram on the kit itself so that you can see the general placement of the parts that you're installing. It's not the case for any loose parts, but it is the case for the kits. And one of the complaints that we deal with is that it seems like nothing is ever in English, but the drawing is in a universal language. You should be able to read it no matter what language that you speak. So that's it right there. There's your pressure washer pump with your check valve. So because this is a brand new pressure washer that we are performing this demonstration with, the check valves that are in it are still in good condition, so I don't intend to actually put the new ones in. I'll be able to show you removal and installation with the existing parts. So I'm gonna set this aside for the time being. So like I said, we're gonna start with the pressure gauge. Now the pressure gauge is important to remove because you don't want to damage it in the process of trying to remove any of the other caps. So for that, to remove it, we're gonna use the 14 millimeter combination wrench. You're gonna have to give it a little oomph to break it loose because the Germans do install Loctite on this particular set of threads. I like to leave my protective cover on the pressure gauge so that we don't damage it. So you'll see we have some Loctite on the actual gauge itself right here. So you'll want to wire brush that and clean it up before you reinstall it. You can use Teflon tape if necessary, but Loctite's pretty handy to use. There are also some sealing O-rings, or excuse me, there are also some sealing aluminum washers for getting the gauge to line up just right. With your Loctite, as long as you haven't had to remove it and reinstall it several times, you can generally get it back to about the right position, but in some cases, you may have to dig out those and put fresh ones in. We do carry those as well. We'll have further information on that in the description below. So now we have the pump head, pressure gauge removed. Five of the six caps are identical with the exception of the one that has the pressure gauge. I like to remove it first because it just gets it out of the way. I'm not gonna strip the hex on any of the other caps. That's gonna be a 22 millimeter wrench. Now, you can use an impact gun to remove them. I encourage you to be very cautious when both removing or installing these with an impact gun. Easy to cross thread or to round off your hex on your cap. So be cautious of that. So we've taken off the one valve cap. We're gonna set this aside. And once we move past the check valves, we're gonna leave this stuff uninstalled, but I'll show you generally how to remove the check valves and then reinstall them. So we've taken out our large valve cap. Now for the remaining five. So we've removed all six of the check valves, So we removed all six of the check valve caps. To remove the actual check valves themselves, you'll need needle nose pliers. One of the great things about Krenzler pumps over most other brands is that they have these nice little nipples on the top of the check valve for you to be able to grab with your needle nose pliers. In some cases, if it's a particularly old pump, you can have some difficulty trying to get them out. But when you go to do so, if you struggle, be cautious that the plastic cage can actually become separated from the seat. So the valve cage has a metal seat on the bottom and it clips together. Right there. So if you are having trouble getting it out, if there's been a lot of cavitation, the check valve might be stuck down inside the housing, you may have to break the cage off of the top of it and then use a pick to dig out the seat from inside. It takes some finesse, it's going to take a little bit of effort, but most of these pumps for your lots of commercial applications and residential applications, you're not gonna see a whole lot of crud in there to prevent these from coming out. But if they've been running some really harsh water through it, sometimes oxidation or calcification can build up and make these kind of difficult to remove. So you might, in some cases, have a little bit of struggle. So here are, there are all six of your check valves. Now, under each one of the check valves is an O-ring that seals the check valve to the valve housing. So we dig each one of them out. So there, we've removed all six of the O-rings for the check valves. Now, like I mentioned before, we're going to just reinstall this kit, and I'm gonna show you how to do one of them right now, just so that you can see how it's done. The other task that will go along with installing the new check valve, you're going to take the old O-ring off of the valve cap. You may find some Loctite on these threads as well, not to mention some oxidation is always possible. So this is a good time to take and hit these with a wire brush. Don't put them under a wire wheel for too long, because of course you can start to wash away the brass, but you want to clean them up nice and shiny if possible. So then when we go to reinstall the O-ring, another reason why I like this particular pick, I set the O-ring on the valve cap, like so, using my thumb, holding the side of the valve cap, going right through the center of the O-ring. There's another look at it. I take the pick and walk the O-ring around and slide it down onto the valve cap like so. Then your new O-ring will go down inside the valve housing. making sure that it gets all the way seated down on the bottom of the cavity. And you can use the check valve to actually get it to seat down in there. And I just drop it down in and push just a little bit. Then it is wise to hand tighten these onto the valve housing. If for some reason your ring doesn't get underneath the check valve in the right position, or especially in other pressure washer pumps, if the check valve flips askew while you're trying to install the valve cap, you can crush the check valve and you're back to square one again. And you probably won't find out until you fire the pressure washer back up. So I like to thread them in by hand. The cleaner the threads, the easier it is to do so. Use my ratchet to snug it up. And then you can snug it up with the combination wrench, but I like to hit it once or twice with the impact gun, and then I know I have a good seal. So there we have the removal and the installation of your check valves. Now, the diagnosis part, when we pull our check valves, we're looking for debris or material preventing this check valve from opening and closing all the way. And the spring pushes it downward. So anything that is keeping it, like the pick is right now, preventing that valve plate from seating, that's going to cause a check valve not to operate correctly. Most times you can see the debris that's in there, but we've always recommended what's called the suction test. Not a lot of people are turned on by this particular test, but it's very effective. So we take the check valve, put the seat to your lips and suck. You should feel almost no air, if any, come through the check valve from that direction, because it's only permitting flow in one direction. So that right there is a good check valve. The pulsation accompanied pressure loss will only happen if one or two of these is obstructed. If you have two or more that are obstructed, then most often you're gonna lose all pressure completely. So other things to look for, like I said before, if freezing conditions may have caused these cages start to warp, or if you've been running hot water or maybe a lot of DI water through your pressure washer pump, you can start to get some wear on the check valves that will cause them to not want to actuate properly. So this is what we're looking at whenever we find pressure loss to also be accompanied by pulsation. So there you have it. We've gone over pressure loss due to check valve problems, and we've done the diagnosis of the check valves as well as how to remove them and reinstall them. The next segment's going to be on unloader valve related pressure loss, and we'll dive into that next. So if you have any questions, leave it in the comments below. Don't forget to like it, subscribe, and thanks for joining me, the original Josh, with Krenzlee USA, pressure washer perfection.
Krenzlee USA, pressure washer perfection.